So how long have you lived out here in Montauk?
1963.
Uta Hagen introduced you to Montauk, is that true?
Indirectly. I was trying to cast a play of mine called Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? And I thought Uta Hagen might be very interesting to play Martha. She lived in Montauk, and I was coming out to persuade her to be in Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? And I came along the old highway and discovered I had to live out here.
Yeah.
And I was hoping that Virginia Woolf would become some kind of commercial success, and it was, and so I've lived out here ever since. That was 1963, which makes it 46 years I've been out here.
Wow. What's your job as a playwright?
To make people pay more attention to the things they should be paying attention to.
What do you think?
Like things like democracy, politics, government, their own lives, whether they live their lives fully or not, what their reaction is to other people, their responsibilities to themselves and other people. All art, to be any good, has to be useful. Decoration is not enough.
Have you had a driving force that you would say is a common thread? Not necessarily a thematic thread, but something you wanted us to get?
I can talk about everybody else's plays except my own. I don't know what the hell they're about. They're about what happens to the people in them, and I write them because I need to write them. I make the assumption that they'll be useful. They may change a few minds about some things. Yeah, you hope that.
But let's talk about...
But I write plays because I'm a playwright.
To talk about plays, the character that I was most influenced by was Laura in The Glass Menagerie.
Oh, yeah?
Because of the just gentleness, you know. I guess because I was a gay kid, and I just felt really gentle, and I could never understand any kind of cruelty, you know. And it just seems to me like...
Well, that's what Tennessee wrote against so much, intentional cruelty. That's what he wrote most about.
What do you think you write the most about?
As I said, make people participate in their own lives more fully.
The one that I always thought was very interesting is the sandbox with Grandma.
That was about this very bizarre family who had adopted a baby and did everything they possibly could to destroy it. But the baby left when he was 18 years old and didn't get destroyed. He was adopted into that family. And he didn't like the adoptive mother or the adoptive father because they were appalling people. But he did like Grandma, who was around the house. They didn't like her either, and they didn't like him, so these two were allies. I don't know who my parents were since I was adopted.
Yeah, you never did find out.
No, it was impossible back in those days. Couldn't find out. Laws.
You recently, about 4 years ago, you lost your partner, didn't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, 35 years together.
He was a
sculptor.
A sculptor.
Yeah.
Right.
Met him in Canada when he was still going to college. And we were together for 35 years, which is, you know, pretty lucky. Find somebody that you care that much about, who cares that much about you. And the loss is pretty rough. It's only 5 years now, and I'm still getting over it, trying to.
Uh-huh. And you live here now alone.
Yeah. Well, the only thing you can do to get through any loss like that is to remember it's the person who's dying who's doing all the losing. The losing that you're doing is nothing compared to that.
Well, you never did really go west. You stayed here in New York.
No.
But you were
fine. The idea of doing screenwriting was so appalling to me that I was never tempted. Movies and television are concerned with the lowest possible denominator, the worst and laziest possible audience that they can possibly get.
Well, I was going to say, maybe that's because that's what the audience is lazy.
The audience is being trained to want junk. If the audience were given the opportunity to like something better, I'm convinced they would. Movies and television are very popular, and then they destroy the public taste.
So now they've melded into Broadway.
Well, it's getting worse and worse.
It is.
But some of us are going to the barricades.
One of my favorite films, I know you're not going to agree, is indeed your adaptation of their adaptation of Virginia Woolf.
There was no adaptation. Why you liked it is the fact that, with the exception of two sentences, every word in the screenplay I wrote.
What did you think of Tell? I know you thought she was too young.
I was promised by Warner Brothers, I was promised Betty Davis and James Mason. That would have been a much better film.
Mm-hmm.
However, it's better than, as Beckett said, better than a kick in the teeth.
Did you ever speak to Betty Davis about the role?
Yeah, of course. She was enraged.
She was.
That was taken away from her.
I loved her.
Well, I hate all movie music. I saw a rough cut of the film in Hollywood before they put the movie music in.
Uh-huh.
Much better film. Tougher. All that awful, soppy string music that was written made the film a little sentimental.
You said you live with your characters and you put them in basically improv settings in your head and you work through them. You're dealing with a lot of your own humanity and a lot of your own stuff.
I hope so.
You must know Edward Albee very well.
I know how he reacts to things. I don't know whether I know me very well. I know how he reacts to stuff, and I know how I can translate that into more interesting characters.
I want to ask you who your favorite playwright is, but I think I know who your answer is.
My favorite playwright? Well, my favorite playwright is me, of course.
Good.
Any honest person who you ask that to will say that. Do I think I'm the finest playwright around? No. Sam Beckett's a lot better. There are a lot of playwrights I look up to and very, very much. But I'm my favorite. I'd be a damn fool if I weren't.
And you're still, damn it, you're still writing.
The older I get, this word still keeps coming into conversation more. You still do this, you still do that. Is something supposed to happen to your mind when you get to 81 or something? Most people stop doing anything when they possibly can, called retirement, because they've been doing stuff that they don't like.
As one of America's great playwrights, you must know something that the rest of us don't. And I'm wondering if you're ever going to directly tell us.
It's so simple. Always tell the truth. Don't sell out. Don't compromise. Try to be nice to people. And you can get along. You end up not idiotically happy, but you end up with the ability to go to the next day and do something useful.
I want to boil your work down to something. I want you to boil it down to something. But
anything that can be defined in one sentence should be one sentence long.
Do you have any one sentence comments?
No.
It's in your next play, right?
Of course.
Edward Albee, thank you so much.
Welcome.